we're just a stone's throw from the Delaware River. We've got some water to contend with ourselves. A steady rain falling at Lincoln Financial Field. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line with Eli Manning and the New York Giants. Now a two-time 1,000-yard rusher for the Bears. This is Jordan Howard. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second and nine, Wentz, and incomplete. He was looking for Miles Sanders out of the backfield, and that takes us from second to third down.
I think we'll see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and nine. Working from the gun, Wentz. It's caught by Sanders. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A big pickup there for the Eagles' first down, 18 yards.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him. Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. Here's Miles Sanders, the rookie second rounder from Penn State. They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Go. 180.
29. Come off the ball.
Now Wentz on third down. And he connects with Ertz. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 14 yards there and an Eagle first down.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in this paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone?
Well, we've seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half, unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting him the ball out of the passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is because he catches it well, creates a mismatch. You're going to cover him with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he can win every battle.
Wentz throwing complete to Arcega Whiteside. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. Again, it's Wentz. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Alec Ogletree. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. Running it with the NFL's Offensive Rookie of the Year a season ago, Saquon Barkley. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 10 yards, good for a Giant first down. Barkley had his biggest game yardage-wise against these Eagles last year pretty early on in the season. 130 on the ground, 99 more through the air on 9 catches. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Shotgun now for Manning. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Well, he'll definitely say that that's one he should have held on to. But when you're playing in elements like this, sometimes those bullet passes, those ones with a little bit of pace on them, they can be difficult to hold on to.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. Throwing again. Manning over the middle, and it's incomplete. Golden Tate, his intended receiver. But now it'll be third down.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. From the gun, it's Manning. And the throw there going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Fourth down, so on is the punter, Riley Dixon. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. Fielded just inside the 20. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Well, CD, let's look at Philadelphia's season here as they come back out here for this next drive. 5-7, three straight losses, but this last one was the real head scratcher. 37-31 to the Miami Dolphins. And they had a chance to pull into a tie with the Cowboys because the Cowboys are 6-6. Still a chance at that division, obviously, but that was not a good look against Miami.
To put it mildly, and while they have the opportunity to still win the NFC East, remember, if they win out, they control their own destiny and they'll win the division. That's getting tougher and tougher to hang your hat on. They're 0-7 now when trailing in the fourth quarter this season. They finish with the NFC East, all within their own division. Home against the Giants, at Washington, home for Dallas, at the Giants. Looks like a good schedule and manageable, but they're not playing at a level where it's manageable. They're playing at a level right now where any of those teams can beat them. And that's what Philadelphia has to figure out, because it just doesn't make sense that a roster this good is sitting there at 5-7 at this point in the season.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Running with Howard. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. It's a second down run with Sanders. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 10 yards there and an Eagle first down.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
Check, 47. Watch the fly.
Right back to Sanders on first down. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Now they'll throw it. Wentz. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Nelson Agholor, the intended receiver, and it's third and short.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss him? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah,
what happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
This is taken in by Jeffrey. He's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. A 5-yard touchdown catch as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Good bounce back drive right there through the pick on drive number one. Drive number two leads them right down the field into the end zone.
Agree totally. Excellent bounce back, tremendous poise, confidence never lost, and obviously he transmitted that to his teammates as well. What a really nice drive.
The point after through the raindrops, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Well, Charles is taking a step back here for a second, looking at the New York Giants. They've now lost 8 straight following their previous defeat to the Green Bay Packers, 31-13. That 8-game losing streak, they're worse since 2004. And to be honest, there just aren't a lot of positives to draw from right now.
No, there really aren't. And you look at the quarterback. They drafted him, Daniel Jones. So much controversy about taking him so high. In a lot of cases, in a lot of games.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Timmy Jernigan with a sack. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
To try again after the sack. Manning, open target here, Darius Slayton. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Well, it's kind of interesting when you think about Eli Manning and what he's done in his career against the Eagles, because it's one of the teams that he struggled the most with, just 10-20 in 30 career games head-to-head, including 2 losses last year in 2018, with the Giants losing both in Week 6 and Week 12 to Philadelphia. Nothing doing on that one, and it'll be fourth down.
Well, the good thing about covering any game I do with you is I know that there's no problem with rhythm. Now, what we're watching offensively, a little bit of a problem there.
Yeah, punt on the first drive, looking at another one here, just a little slow. And, you know, they were talking about a fast start, but that hasn't been the case.
Yeah, and let's face it, any team we cover always talks about a
fast
start.
That's true.
But it's not necessarily going to happen just because they say so. And whether it's the script, whether it's, you know, just what they're going through, whether they're seeing different defenses, they're going to have to figure it out as this game moves on.
Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out 1st and 10. Wentz and the Eagles now with a 1st and 10 at their own 22. A quick throw there out to Jeffrey. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It'll be a loss of 1, and it'll be 2nd and 11.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
And he's upended after a gain of 4, up to the 25-yard line.
But you've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
Squeeze, squeeze, double, double.
Wentz off the fake handoff to Howard. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Alec Ogletree coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it also brings up 4th. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. On 4th down, out is the punter Cameron Johnston to boot it away. Back deep, Golden Tate. That's pulled in at the 32. It'll go as a 50-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. The New York set to take the field. It hasn't gone particularly well for them, that's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic. Meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe hit them on those short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner and get out of the way. Don't cause any extra stress on your offense.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and 6. A quick throw, here's Shepard. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it, no yardage. The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. Working from the gun, Manning. Driven down. Derek Barnett able to maneuver in for the sack. And partner, it's safe to say that the secondary really contributed to that sack.
Yeah, nickel set, 5 defensive backs. They covered everything. Nowhere to go with the football. But my question is, why didn't he throw it away?
Here's Riley Dixon now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well, and he's been right.
It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
On second down now, it's Sanders. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. This will be a loss of 3 and now a much tougher third down looming.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
On third and long, it's Wentz. That's complete to Arcega Whiteside. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down.
Receivers love having the reputation of being go-to guys on third down. And he was fighting like he really wanted to have that reputation, didn't he? I mean, he came very close to making that a first down.
Broke the one tackle, but couldn't spring himself free. Here's Cameron Johnston now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. On the return, it's Tate. 51 yards on the punt there. And out will come the offense as they take over. And the Giants ready to come out now. The results for them so far, not that great. Well, not good at all. 3 drives, 3 punts.
Yeah, and now what you're doing is you're looking at your play sheet. You're trying to figure out what you're going against defensively. I wonder, are they showing them something they haven't seen or anticipated in practice, and maybe that's throwing them off? Or do they just have to go to a different play calling section and try and run some offense that way?
Barkley with a carry on first down, and he'll get about 4. So second and 6 forthcoming. Fletcher Cox there for the tackle.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Now this pass into the hands of Saquon Barkley, and he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. they become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
CD, with that incompletion, let's look at some of the big games week 13. So these are ones that our crew probably think of the biggest four. Let's rank them 1-4 as far as how big they are and what they mean. Baltimore at Buffalo, San Fran at New Orleans, KC at New England, Seattle at the Rams. How would you rank those? What do you think?
Well, this is going to sound self-serving since I'm working San Francisco and New Orleans, but to me that's the number one game because the number one seed in the NFC will be determined that week for that moment. Okay, the winner of that becomes the number one seed. I think the number two game, Seattle at the Rams, because Seattle's trying to maintain pace with San Francisco or become the number one team in the NFC West, and the Rams have to have it if they have any designs of making the playoffs. The number three game, Baltimore at Buffalo. Buffalo's announced its presence, that big win on Thanksgiving Day over Dallas, but Baltimore's the hottest team, the best team in the league over the last 8 weeks. And then you finish up Kansas City, New England. How is that the number four game?
I know.
Hard to believe, but it is in this state, in this instance. I feel like Eli Manning has just gone from downfield bomber to a guy who can complete everything.
He can hit him underneath now,
can't he? Yeah, we just saw that there with that pass completion. The maturity of a veteran taken with the defense will give him.
Now Saquon Barkley. Tackle made that time by Brandon Graham. That's something we saw over and over again in Barkley's rookie season. He had 91 catches last year, most ever by a rookie running back. Part of a fantastic rookie campaign that saw him go over 2,000 total yards. Now whistles here and a flag down. I think a giant jumped early. And that false start penalty is certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. After the penalty, they go with Barkley. And a 6-yard gain gets them right around the 43.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
The Giants on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and nine. Throwing now is Manning. He's going to let this one go deep. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything that warranted a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
That's
going
to go as a loss of one on first down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
The loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Shotgun now for Wentz. He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down.
And that's when it's fun to play defense, when you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football and spill the play. That's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
They wound up getting nothing out of that second down completion. So now here's third and 10.
Go. Luigi! 55.
Coming to you.
Now Howard. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Here's Cameron Johnston now as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Just a net of 34 there following a punt of 44 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
Well, partner, Thanksgiving in the rearview mirror, Black Friday, Cyber Monday, all gone. And now if you look at the top four seeds right now as we hit, is it the quarter pole or the three-quarter pole?
It is the quarter pole, and we get to thank our NFL reporter Randy Moss, who also has a great background in the sport of kings, for letting us know that's one of the most misused terms in that sport. It is the quarter pole, right? What are they headed for the home stretch is what he also said about it. I can't wait to see how this thing ends.
Well, we got New England and Baltimore, the top two seeds in the AFC, Seattle and New Orleans in the NFC. You think it stays that way at the end?
I think it's going to be a heck of a battle. I think Baltimore, yes. New England's going to get a battle from Buffalo, but I think they're going to stay in the spot. Seattle, they're going to battle San Francisco. They're just going to trade it back and forth, and it's going to come down to week 17, I believe, to decide that one. And New Orleans, yes, they will retain a top two spot.
He was out there waving his arms saying, throw it here, dropped it, not a good look.
Well, all I can do is just look at him with contempt on that one. As a defensive back, I'm saying, not as an announcer. Just like, really?
A little bit of a diva look, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so, because I think what happens is he just had too much time to think. He's wide open now. Here comes the ball. And he doesn't concentrate and drops it.
That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Eagles offense back out onto the field. Still more than a minute to go, so you know, there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have three timeouts at their disposal as well. So that changes everything that you're doing here. Without those timeouts, you can only work the sidelines, hoping to get out of bounds. Here, the middle of the field's still available because you can call timeout and regroup.
Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. Now, if you're a fan of punting, and I know that not many people are, but this game kind of turning into one for you.
Well, it's okay if it's a skills contest, right? We're really into it then, but not during the course of an actual game. This has turned into a field position game, though. Sometimes a better punter may actually determine the outcome.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now Wentz. And he finds his tight end, it's Ertz. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Here we go. Wentz now 11 to 15 through the air. Here's first and 10. From the gun, it's Wentz. And he'll hit Jeffrey, complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
Get ready.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. Right hash mark of 42-yard attempt. And the kick by Elliott is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock and pretty much drained everything before they put the field goal on the board as they headed into the half.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The New York set to take the field.
Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will they be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'm going to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
So we have reached halftime with our score 10-0 as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, this is taken at his 4. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The New York set to take the field. They come out here with a 0 on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working?
And now the ball comes out. Manning lost it. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And they're going to be set up in the red zone at the 15. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Wentz. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league, those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Eagles take advantage of good field position on the turnover to cash this one in. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll get it up just past the 20, and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. The Giants offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions. But some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you. But if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. They'll run it again with Barkley. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He lost two there, and it's third down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
On third and long, it's Manning. And Ingram hauls it in. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A good pickup there, 21 yards. A healthy Evan Ingram, that could be a great elixir for New York this year. A season ago, he only played in 11 games because of the injuries, 35 catches, which was a dip down from two seasons ago when Ingram caught 64 passes. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, he often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. On second down, here's Barkley. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
And Brandon, you know that expression? He just does what he does. It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL. And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
They keep it with Barkley on first down. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8.
Don't get nervous. Check safety. Get it.
Manning going to hand it off to Barkley. And he's going to be met at about the 43. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now Manning. And that is incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And the punt team on now as this one sent away. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They go with Howard to begin the drive. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3.
Here we go again.
On play action, Wentz. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. and reading your keys. You always hear about that and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. A first down run, good for about three. Second and seven coming up. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
It's coming this way, coming this way.
Wentz now to throw. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Great coverage there all around. Really didn't have many options to throw the football.
Very little chance that that one was going to be completed. Every receiver was locked up.
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. Working from the gun, Wentz. And he connects with Ertz. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 34-yard line.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he'll finally be taken down at the 18. It's a gain of 16 and an Eagle first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just...
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Alshon Jeffrey, his second touchdown of the night. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Elliott good on the extra point, and the lead is now 24. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And here comes the Giants offense back out onto the field. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Again, it's Barkley. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
He's definitely tough to get down. We just saw it right there. But how about what we did see? Pursuit, wrap up, and then the big finish with the tackle.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Operating from the gun, Manning. And that will be incomplete. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
Here's Riley Dixon now, as he's on to punt for New York. So possession goes over here on the punt. And out now come the Eagles.
And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion, but I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating, there he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete. Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz, stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we've played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
The Eagles on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Now Wentz gets this to his running back, Jordan Howard. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first.
Call it a 1 yard gain on the play. And that's going to make it 4th down.
Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion. What you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And New York set to take the field.
And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Manning and the Giants come up now 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33.
You can't block me. Come on.
Here's Manning to throw. Catch made by Slayton. Now, I know it's an emotional game, Charles. You can't do that.
And when you get into your film sessions and you argue your case with your coaches, that's exactly what they say at the end. You just can't do it. It costs your team.
Let's go. 60 Pittsburgh.
Let's go one more.
Let's go.
Manning now on 1st down. He gets it complete to Latimer. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5.
Let's go.
19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it 1st and goal.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window, he fired a bullet in there for the completion. Defensively, a solid response after giving up back-to-back first downs.
What a game this defense continues to play, huh?
Yeah, they've been aggressive from the first snap, and they've controlled this ball game. But right now, if you're on the other side of the ball, you've got to match that aggressiveness. No points so far in this game. Moving the football, got to be that way to go against them.
And he finds Shepard. Touchdown, Giants. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Giants are able to draw a bit closer.
So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no zero.
50 plant.
Are you? You're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle. And a nice move will yield nothing as he stopped behind the line. Now after the touchdown, here's Rosas on to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Let's go.
The Eagles coming out as they get ready. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. The throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. 17 yards and a first down for Philly. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, this is a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. Looks like he's going to get a couple here on this first down carry, and that'll make it second and eight. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
All day, defense, all day.
On second down, it's Sanders. Another 2-yard gain there, but they'll need to do better this time. It's third and six.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
The Eagles on third down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. This will be third and six. Here's Wentz to throw. And Jeffrey's got it. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 40. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10, right at the 40. Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Wentz. And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up third down. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart, and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
The Eagles on third down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This is third and four. To throw is Wentz. Caught by the tight end Ertz. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 17 yards and a first down for Philly. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
Throwing is Wentz. It's caught by Aguilar.
And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Try to punch it in with Howard. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback and makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Howard all alone in the backfield on second and goal.
Three down.
Throwing now is Wentz. And that is caught. It's Aguilar for the Eagle touchdown. A one-yard touchdown pass. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because this certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You could see them sag on their sideline, and I think this one might just be over.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And New York set to take the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on, get it done, and maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward. Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it.
And he's hit and taken down. Eli sacked. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as he'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. It's Manning. He's going to let it fly. It got his man complete. And he makes it all the way down to the 31. It's a big-time play there for the G-Men. 43 yards. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set.
Check 53's Mike.
Throw
Going on first down is Manning.
Let's make these babies cry all the way now.
And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Rodney McLeod that time able to knock it away.
Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
Manning again here on second and 10. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10.
Ready?
Manning to throw once more. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's fourth down. Well, this secondary has done such a good job of frustrating these receivers tonight. Another example right there on the deep ball.
Sometimes when the sun goes down and it's just the bright lights in the stadium, puts a little extra spring in their step, doesn't it? And that's what we're seeing from the defenders. Doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. Deep ball, short ball, and that was a deep one there. They're making plays on the football, contesting everything. Now, if this was a clear day in September, I'd say this is well within his range. I'd feel very confident about this kick, but let's be honest about it. In these elements, the difficulty level gets ratcheted up by at least a factor of five.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. So it's a victory here for the Philadelphia Eagles, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better, and that got it done in this one.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Eagles are winners here as we say so long from Philadelphia.